Good morning, YouTube family. Today we're going to harvest our container grown Pontiac red potatoes. So stick around. We're going to dump some buckets out and see what we got. We're ready to get started. So these are a determinate potato, and remember that how we talked about that on our part three of our potato series, how they don't grow any higher than the green point. So everything from the about right here in this bucket down, that's where the potatoes are going to be. So all the dirt that's up here above is not going to have any potatoes in it. So when I dump this bucket out, I'm going to lay the contents over on the side, and I'm going to show you that that line of distinction there, so you understand what I'm talking about. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to trim all the tops, and I'm going to get them out of my way, and I'm going to leave about 10 or 12 inches of the stem on the plant. So when I get to harvesting these potatoes out of the pile of dirt, I have something to grab onto, like a handle, and it helps me to shake the taters loose, and it's easier to harvest. So let me get started on that. And pull my stems up, and I leave about 12 inches, 10 or 12 inches. You can throw this in your compost pile if you have one. That's how you want to get it ready. So let me go ahead and get the rest of them trimmed and get that part over with, and we'll start dumping buckets. Okay, I got all the tops trimmed off. We're ready to get started. So let's see what we got. These buckets are a little bit on the muddy side because we've had some real heavy rains the last couple of days. So it's best to harvest your potatoes out of your containers if you let them dry a day or two before you try to do this. But I don't have much choice because today's the only day it's not going to rain for the next 6 days. I want to get them out so they don't root rot. So let's get started. You can see that right about here, that's the green point. That's as deep as we planted these potatoes, and they shouldn't grow anything above here. So when I pull it over, I know that the potatoes aren't going to go any higher than the green point. See the green point right here? That's about as high as the potatoes will produce. So let's break it open. There we go. We grab some of our handles. Let's pull up some taters. See what we got. That's a nice pretty one. First bucket. Come up a little closer here. That's our first bucket. If y'all remember, on I did that video on the reclamation box, so I can reclaim all my spent container soil. So here's a big pile of container soil. We're gonna save that and put it in the reclamation box over there, and in the spring I'll re-amend this soil and get those micronutrients brought back up and revitalize that soil, and I'll mix it in with some peat and other potting mix, and then we use that in our containers for next year. So let's get the other three dumped out and see what we got for a total. See all this root growth all around the bottom like this and all up the sides, that's a good sign. You've had good root development, and that's what you want for potatoes. Now just a pretty good little pile of red potatoes. Let's weigh them and see what we got. Remember, these skins are very soft, so you don't want to rub them too hard or be too rough on them, because that skin will just peel right off. And also, banging them around too much, you could bruise them up. So I'm being a little rough with them because I'm in a hurry for the camera. But take your time when you're doing this and try to get them harvested gently. I used to not worry about these little things, but Nancy goes through and she picks all those out and saves them and makes tater candy. So she'll bring you a film on that in the days ahead on her Asian Redneck Fusion cooking series. Tater candy. We'll take these in the house. We'll put them in cardboard boxes. We'll set them in there where they're not touching each other, and let them sit in those boxes for about 2 weeks and let these skins cure. And they'll toughen up some, and after they toughen up, at that point you can start eating them. So these will last you a few months, several months. Tater candy. Need a bigger bucket. Okay, there's four containers worth. Set it on the scale and see what we got. The outside numbers are the pounds, the inside number are kilograms. So as you can see, we got 30 pounds. Let's take off a pound for the bucket, but we're looking at 29 pounds of red potatoes out of four containers. That ain't really all that bad, so I ain't gonna complain about that. Thank you, Lord, for that harvest. So if you like our videos, I ask you to give our channel a subscribe and hang around and be a part of our YouTube family. And always remember, on a harvest like this, to thank the Lord, for by his hands we are fed. Give us, Lord, our daily bread.
Amen. Have a blessed day. Thanks for watching our videos. We really love making them. If you like our videos, please like our Facebook page to get the latest tips and tricks. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the newest video. Like it. It would really inspire and encourage us. But most importantly, share it to encourage others. We'll welcome your comments and questions. Thank you. Have a blessed day.